More than 2,400 healthcare workers in Georgia have tested positive for the virus. That amounts to nearly 10% of Georgia's total cases. The numbers highlight the need for protective equipment for medical staffs. And this week, the state announced a new decontamination system that can sanitize 80,000 N95 masks per day.
This system will give us the ability to recycle critical supplies, and it is currently available to all medical facilities, long-term care facilities, as well as first responders.
The solution sparked by a couple's conversation at the dinner table. More than 95 Georgia facilities have already signed up to use it, and they only have to pay for shipping. The Reveal investigator Rebecca Lindstrom shows us how it works.
In this COVID-19 crisis, great ideas seem to start with simple questions. In this case, why not decontaminate N95 masks so hospitals don't run out?
It's overwhelming to think that it started with an after-dinner conversation.
Can you take big, big, deep breaths?
Lori Hamama is a family doctor. Her husband, an engineer for Battelle Memorial Institute. He remembered research 5 years earlier at the request of the FDA to design a method to decontaminate and reuse N95 masks in exactly this kind of emergency situation.
Battelle's been involved in decontamination and PPE for decades.
Matt Vaughn, who leads contract research, says building off that knowledge, Battelle was able in just 9 days to turn shipping containers into a system that would treat thousands of masks with a pressurized vapor of hydrogen peroxide.
We've got agreements in place with over 150 different institutions and facilities that now can take advantage of that. First responders, nursing homes, assisted living facilities, dialysis centers.
Thanks to a $400 million federal grant, shipping and cleaning the masks is free. Battelle says masks can safely be decontaminated up to 20 times. They'll be marked each time they go through the system. Battelle has an office in Atlanta. They've prepared to staff 3 shifts a day if needed.
We're here to help, and we're confident that we can help provide a buffer for the nurses, the doctors, and those first responders who are taking tremendous risks to keep all of us safe, and we're grateful for that.
And grateful for the dinner conversation that sparked the idea.
And Battelle is now working with the FDA to approve methods to decontaminate other items in short supply like goggles and gowns. They hope to add face shields to that list beginning on next week.